Hello friends, welcome to EPG Pathshala. Today we are going to discuss news and elections. This lecture is a part of your paper News and Society. In this lecture, we will try to understand the importance of news media in a democratic country like India, especially during the electoral process. The lecture will also help us in exploring the complicated relationship between news and election process. As we know that the media provides an essential channel for all kinds of communication that help the society to exist and function. In modern democratic societies which require representative governments, media plays a very critical role in ensuring the vibrant dissemination of information for the existence, subsistence and development of the constituents of the society. So this lecture will provide us with an opportunity to understand the nuances of the relationship between the media, particularly news and democratic elections. In this context, this lecture will help us to understand how media influences and shapes the electoral politics in India and how the news media covers the election. The three key factors involved at this juncture are media, politics and society. Politics is represented by the state and society is primarily represented by the electorate and by civil society and similar stakeholder of governance. Learning outcome, we will be able to understand the relevance of news in a vibrant democracy like India and also think critically about the role of media in the electoral process. We will also be able to assess how the relationship between media, society, state and the structure of news is in state of flux. News in democratic election. News typically connotes the presentation of new information. The news is information about current events, something that was not known, information about recent developments and happenings as reported by newspaper, periodicals, radio or television. In other words, the news is the timely report of events, facts and opinions and attracts a significant number of people. The news is a new piece of information about a meaningful and recent event that affects the audience and is of interest to them. Why is it relevant to an election? Modern democratic societies cannot be imagined without media. Television, newspapers, the radio and the internet are the main sources of information for citizens all around the globe. But what does this mean for the functioning of political system and electoral processes? India is a constitutional democracy with a parliamentary system of government, and at the heart of the system is a commitment to hold regular, free and fair elections. India is the only country which began its democratic journey on the basis of universal adult franchise. It requires to be mentioned that universal adult franchise in all the Western democratic countries are a post-World War II phenomenon. Elections are the feature of representative democracy, allowing the people's regular input in choices about leaders and policy. And yet they are also competitive processes unleashing conflict and tensions that, if not constructively managed, could potentially destabilize the fabric of states and societies. It is essential, therefore, that the media play an active role in ensuring that such tensions and conflict are minimized or eliminated. The media can do this by sensitizing the electorate and the rest of the citizenry on the proper conduct of elections. Democracy always rests on the right to freely express diverse opinion and on the votes of informed citizen. News media plays an essential role in the electoral process by assuring the broadcasting of news and diverse opinions. Media makes it possible to gain a deeper knowledge of candidates, parties and their programs. Journalists contribute to the effective participation of citizens in democratic debate, especially by ensuring that issues of public interest remain at the center of election campaign. A free and fair election is not only about the freedom to vote and the knowledge of casting a vote, but also about a participatory process where voters can engage themselves in public debates and have ample information about the parties, policies, candidates and election process itself in order to make an informed choice. Democracy requires that active participation of people, and the media keep citizens engaged in the governance by informing, educating and mobilizing the public. In this context, Thomas Jefferson said that if he had to choose between a government without newspaper or newspapers without a government, he would pick the latter. This shows that media's role is crucial for conducting the elections in a democratic society. In a democratic election, the freedom of expression with no media would be a contradiction in terms. The media is also referred to as the fourth realm of the state, that is, the fourth pillar in support of the essential tripod of government, the legislative and the judiciary. The media can be categorized into two broad categories, the print media and the electronic media. The print media comprises of newspapers, magazines, journals and periodicals. And the electronic media includes the radio, television and all related modern means of communication, such as the computer and the internet. There are two types of media: information rich, which comprises of the elites who seek information from a diversity of elite specialist personnel. Political elites also pay attention to the media to monitor what coverage they receive and what issues the journalists place onto the public agenda. The second is information poor, which are voters. In this case, politicians deploy the mass media to communicate with voters. Most voters are almost entirely dependent upon the mass media for information about the political process, candidates and issues. Jürgen Habermas defines the media as a space for public disclosure which must guarantee universal access and rational debate in society. But in practice, the free market rules and competition creates restrictions for journalists, and commercial television channels are forced to respond to the interest of advertisers as well as politicians. However, the news media also have other important roles in enabling public participation in electoral practices. These are to educate the voter about the substance of vote in democratic country like India by voting for a suitable and right candidate, to sensitize the voters about the significance of participation in an electoral process, to ensure a responsive, accountable and democratically elected government, imparting knowledge about key components of election manifestos of political parties, providing a platform for the political party and candidates to communicate their message to the electorate and to communicate their concerns, opinions and needs to the parties or candidates, the EMB, the government and to other voters, and to interact on these issues, allowing the parties and candidate to debate with each other, reporting results and monitoring vote counting, scrutinizing the electoral process itself, including electoral management, in order to evaluate the fairness of the process, its efficiency and its probity, providing information that as far as possible avoids inflammatory language, helping to prevent election related violence, relationship between news media, state and society. The relationship of news media, politics and society becomes important in a democratic setup. In a democracy, news media is independent and the electorate has voting rights to elect their representative. In this context, in a representative democracy, both media and the electorate play crucial roles in determining the political situation of the state. In an ideal situation, media and electorate both enjoy full independence of expression of political opinion. There are various perspectives in terms of exploring the interrelation of news, media, politics and society. Media as an institution and its influence on society in terms of its relation with state, largely represented by politics, and electorate that represents society. There are several schools of thought regarding what role media should play in society, especially vis-a-vis political news. In terms of the tripartite relationship of media, politics and society. First, the media strongly influences the politics and society for good or ill. Second, that the media simply reflects what is going on in the state and society at large. This makes media more an effective than a cause. Third, that the interrelationship is an interactive and circular one with no clear line of influence. Fourth, the possibilities that suggest lack of influence in either direction. Among the three, where media, politics and society are three independent complexes of social and cultural practice. Once political news is received by the electorate, they discuss it among themselves. This in turn influences the larger society that comprises larger electorate. Also, since media sustains as a mutual communicative channel with society, political opinion of the electorate often comes back to the media in terms of what the society at large is thinking and opining politically. Next, political parties depend on the media for dissemination of political news, and media also is dependent on political parties for fodder. In other words, politics being the most crucial issue apart from the economy is a modern social constellation. Media reports essentially constitute political news items. Moreover, once the media becomes privatized, many media houses are often owned by business barons who also have political affiliations. Therefore, the tripartite relationship of media, politics, and society emerges when media keeps the electorate politically informed by disseminating political news, which in turn facilitates political opinion formation of the electorate that reflects on the political outcome of an election, which again is reported by the media. Jürgen Habermas, one of the most prominent thinkers from Frankfurt School, coined the term public sphere for explaining society, state, media, and economy in a relational situation. By the public sphere, we mean a realm of our social life in which public opinion can be formed. Public sphere for him does not stand just for public, that is, the individual who assembles, nor is it characterized simply as a crowd. It rather denotes the emergence of an institution that concretizes only through participation of people. The term participation is important here, since public sphere entails a creative and reproducing function of the people involved and not just mere amalgamation of individuals. Public sphere, through the generation of public opinion, lays down a network of checks and balances between the state and the society with the help of media intervention. The role of news media in Indian election. The media of communication has varied through different era, ages and times. As we are living in the 21st century, the mode of communication is very much different from what it was before. However, the role of media has now been transformed with changing times. Since the round the clock television news channels came in the scene, the role and impact of the media is more visible now. Therefore, without the mass media, it is very tough for any political party and leaders to connect with the electorate. The media scene becomes pretty alive during elections in India, especially with the coming of satellite channels. Opinion polls is becoming a regular feature around the election time. Discussion based on poll results have also become popular in media. Candidates and parties use media for campaigning through sponsored direct access spots, paid political advertising, television, debates, and other mechanisms. Mass media has an immense influence both on people and politics. Since it shapes public opinion and its role becomes more powerful, especially during elections, when political parties are sensitive in terms of how the media shows their public appearances. With a free media in a democratic polity and a federal structure of government, India has experienced a long evolution process which has enriched its democratic ethos. Elections in India are the largest democratic electoral exercise in the world by far. Results of these elections are followed closely, not just in India but even beyond, as they have a direct bearing on the lives of its 1.25 billion people and more. In this context, media has been playing a key role in ensuring free and fair elections in India. There are many factors influence the voters in India, where diversity like caste, class, color, creed, religion, region, family, the personality of candidate, parties, news media influence the voting behavior. With the propagation of mass media, they have become very decisive tool for politicians and political parties in reaching out to large masses, which was impossible till a few decades ago. According to Thomas Harrop's thesis, media can influence the voting behavior in four situations. When party loyalties are weak, there are new subjects to cover. Coverage is credible. People rarely discuss politics. Media penetration in India is now deeper. Now citizens can understand politics and the government of the day from the news they watch on television, the news they read in newspapers, and the news they come across on social media spaces. The earliest media studies discounted the effect of mass communication on election, but more recent studies conclude that it can have a huge influence on election outcomes. Indian electorates are more exposed to the media than ever before, and it becomes imperative to test the effect of this on elections. So the media in India has a glorious tradition of safeguarding the democratic rights of our people and exposing all kinds of injustices and inequities by playing the role as a watchdog of democracy. When democratic elections are a relatively new phenomenon for many countries in the world, the free media in India has been educating and informing voters in a non-partisan manner and contributing to the opinion formation of the electorate. Apart from the traditional media, television, print and radio, last decade has witnessed the growing influence of the internet and social media platforms such as Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, YouTube and so on. In the 2014 elections, most political parties and leaders made an attempt to reach out to voters through these new forms of media. They redesigned their official party websites to make them more interactive and open accounts on various social networking platforms to reach out to more voters, especially young ones who are believed to be more technology savvy. Issues and challenges of news media. The survival and success of India's democracy owe a great deal to the vigor and vibrancy of the news media. Both elections and print media has grown enormously in the past few years. The explosion of the broadcast media over the last 10 years has reached many voters with a surge of information, and this has narrowed the gap between politicians and voters. More significant than the numbers is the change in the nature of the media from government control to overwhelming private control. With thousands of newspapers and hundreds of news channels in several languages, Indians are spoiled for choices and diversity. But in many ways, such growth and diversification have come at the cost of accuracy, journalistic ethics and probity. India's news coverage of election campaign has changed dramatically since the late 1990s, when private broadcasters were first allowed to compete with the news coverage of the public. with the news coverage of the public broadcaster Doordarshan. The 2014 Lok Sabha election is a particularly important, and a watershed election, and the role the media was very significant and merits analysis, debate and a certain amount of introspection. It has been argued that it was media logic and not political logic that determined the outcome of the elections. The increasing live coverage of political rallies and presidential style campaigning, the growing link between political interest and owners of media houses, and agenda setting political debates, Indian politics is likely to become more mediatized and the electoral process more Americanized in coming years. The media in India does not merely report, it is a player in Indian politics and elections. While there may not be a concerted attempt to stifle voices which are independent, the media does take sides and tends to editorialize news reporting. Media biases are not a unique feature of the Indian media, it is true of the media everywhere. Now, for example, the tilt was apparent in large sections of the US media coverage of the 2012 presidential election. The Election Commission of India has got powers defined by the Constitution of India, Acts of Parliament and judicial pronouncements to deal with the problem of paid news. It issued measures to its chief electoral officers in the states in June 2010 to check paid news during elections. And the same has been implemented by the state CEOs in the by-election held subsequently. However, the measures and guidelines are not sufficient. In a bid to check the phenomenon of paid news, a special two-member subcommittee of the Press Council of India had recommended in the last week of July 2010 an amendment to Representation of the People's Act 1951 to declare any payment for publication of news as malpractice. Meanwhile, the 23rd member Press Council of India, chaired by G.N. Ray, a retired Supreme Court judge, has unanimously adopted a report of the drafting committee which sought to make changes to the law by bringing the electronic media under its purview. Besides asking the Election Commission to set up a special unit to receive and take action on complaints about paid news in the run-up elections, in the run-up to elections, it further asked the government to set up a committee comprising members of parliament from both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha to hold hearings for suggesting changes in the Representation of the People's Act to prevent the practice of paying for news coverage in newspapers and television channels. Summary. So let us try and summarize what we discussed in this lecture. To sum it up, we can safely submit that media has to play a very important role in the functioning of a democratic country like India. India, being a land of diversities, poses a greater challenge to the smooth functioning of media houses, and therefore we have seen the emergence of thousands of media agencies. The media agencies must stand true to their duties and engage in the free and fair reporting of the electoral process to ensure the healthy functioning of the Indian democratic traditions. In the 21st century, media coverage of elections tremendously influences the creation of public opinion, which in turn can alter the electoral results without doubt. But we can opine that the media houses have their biases, but the role of the media as the fourth pillar of the state is to serve objective news, sans the propaganda. Do attempt the questions in the self-evaluate quadrant for further reading suggestions. Please refer to the third quadrant. Thank you.